सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शांति 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 हरि ओम। सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग द अध्यास भाष्य, दैट इज द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ शंकराचार्य टू हिज कमेंट्री ऑन द ब्रह्म सूत्रास, एंड देयर फाइनली अ क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्क्ड बाय द ऑपोनेंट दैट यू आर सेइंग दैट व्हाट एवर वी सी, व्हाट एवर वी एक्सपीरियंस, एवरीथिंग इज इन द रेलम ऑफ डुअलिटी, एवरीथिंग इज इन द रेलम ऑफ इग्नोरेंस, एवरीथिंग पर्टेन्स टू पीपल हु आर इग्नोरेंट, एंड दैट एवरीथिंग हैपन्स बिकॉज ऑफ अध्यासा, बिकॉज ऑफ अध्यासा प्रीसपोजिंग पुरस्कृत्य एवरीथिंग इज प्रीसपोजिंग अध्यासा। हाउ इज दैट पॉसिबल? दिस इज सच अ ल्यूडिक्रस स्टेटमेंट यू आर मेकिंग। हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल? सो शंकराचार्य गिव्स द लॉजिक हाउ दैट इज पॉसिबल। हाउ डज ही से दैट एवरीथिंग इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन सुपर इम्पोजिशन? बिफोर दैट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज अद्वैता, वॉट इज नॉन डुअलिटी। We need to understand what is non-duality. So, what is non-duality? Non-duality says that the ultimate reality is one. That means it is non-dual. It does not say it is one. It says it is a non-dvaita, dual. Advaita means it is not dual. It's a negative definition. It's not a positive definition. It's a negative definition. Saying that the ultimate reality, ultimate truth is not two. It is not two. It's not told that it is one. Why is it not told that it is one? If you say it is one, that it then it means that there is some zero and there is some two. There is something before that and there is something after that. So if I say a person is sitting in front of me, that means it automatically presupposes that there is a front of me, there is a back of me. If I say a person is standing to the left of me, then it automatically presupposes that there is a center and a right also. So like that, so on and so forth. So that is why the definition of Advaita Vedanta is a negative definition. What does that mean? That means, now let us go to the logic. If suppose we assume that the ultimate reality has to be one, means there is only one reality, there is no two, then that reality has to be infinite. Why? Because if that reality is not infinite in, say, space. Suppose I say that the ultimate reality is only one. There are no two realities. There is only one reality. If that is what we suppose, then if in space there is an area where this reality does not exist, that means in that space some other reality is existing. And if that is the case, then automatically there will be more than one reality. So if a reality is the ultimate reality and only one reality, it has to be infinite in space. There should be no boundaries. Okay. And the same logic applies to the reality. If it has to be only one reality, ultimate reality, it has to be one even in time. Suppose you say this reality is the ultimate reality, but after say so much of time, say after 10 hours, this reality will cease to be the ultimate reality. So that means after that there's some other reality comes into existence. If that is the case, then this reality will not be the ultimate reality, or it will not be the only reality. Again, then we cannot say that it is Advaita. So that means if a reality has to be only one, it has to be infinite, not only in space, but also in time. Similarly, we come to the argument of causation. If there is an ultimate reality and you say that this reality is caused by this, then that reality cannot be the ultimate reality because it is dependent on a cause. So, even in causation, that ultimate reality has to be infinite in the sense it should not have any cause. It should be the causeless. It should be beyond causality. It should be beyond causality. It should be causeless. So, अल्टीमेट रियलिटी बाय डेफिनेशन एंड लॉजिक इट शुड बी ओनली वन इन टाइम स्पेस एंड कॉजेशन, इट शुड बी इन्फिनिट, देर शुड बी नो फाइनाइट बाउंड्रीज. दिस इज द लॉजिक विच शंकराचार्य इज नाउ ब्रिंगिंग टू अस इन अ डिफरेंट वे टू प्रूव दैट वॉट एवर वी सी इन दिस वर्ल्ड इज बेस्ड ऑन प्रीसपोजिशन ऑफ सुपर इम्पोजिशन. वॉट डज ही से? ही सेज उच्यते, वी रिप्लाई. वॉट डज ही रिप्लाई? ही सेज देह इंद्रिय आदिशु ऑन द सबस्ट्रेटम ऑफ और द सबस्ट्रेटा ऑफ बॉडी सेंस ऑर्गन्स माइंड आदि मीन्स एटसेट्रा विच इंक्लूड्स माइंड इंटेलेक्ट एंड ईगो अहम मम अभिमान रहितस्य. फॉर वन पर्सन हु डज नॉट हैव द नोशंस ऑफ मई एंड आई, डज नॉट हैव द नोशंस ऑफ आई एंड माइंड, फॉर सच अ पर्सन प्रमातृत्व अनुपपत्तौ. दैट पर्सन कैन नॉट कॉग्नाइज और देर विल बी नो प्रमातृ फॉर दैट पर्सन, और दैट पर्सन विल हैव नो एजेंट ऑफ द आइडिया ऑफ बीइंग एन एजेंट ऑफ नॉलेज. व्हाई? बिकॉज अ पर्सन हु डज नॉट हैव द नोशन ऑफ आई, हाउ विल दैट पर्सन थिंक दैट आई एम द एजेंट ऑफ नॉलेज? अ पर्सन हु डज नॉट हैव द आइडिया ऑफ माइंड, हाउ विल दैट पर्सन थिंक दैट आई एम गेटिंग दिस नॉलेज? दिस इज माई नॉलेज. आई हैव डन PhD, दिस इज माई नॉलेज. और आई हैव डन इंजीनियरिंग, दिस इज माई नॉलेज. That person will not have, because that person doesn't have the idea of I or mine. That person does not have the idea of I and mine. So in our historical novels, as Swami Vivekananda calls them, Puranas, we get wonderful examples. These truths have been given in the Puranas in a language which is accessible, understandable to the common masses. Puranas don't talk of any truth other than the Upanishads. And the Brahma Sutras do not talk of any truth other than the Upanishads. But these Upanishads have been presented in a language which can be understood by the common masses. We see two incidents we will see from the Puranas. What are the two incidents? One incident is that the gopis, they are taking bath in a pond. Gopis are bathing in a pond. And Shukadeva, that is the son of Vyasa, he is always in the nude, Digambara. He does not wear any clothes, in the nude. Now he is walking by the pond and the gopis are not at all bothering about that person. They are not at all bothering about that person. They are bathing and they are in their own way. The moment Vyasadeva, after some time, came behind Shukadeva, after Shukadeva, his father. And immediately the gopis started running helter-skelter in search of their clothes. So now Vyasa was little surprised at this behavior. He said, "You see, I am older. I am an older person. And that fellow is so young. And you are all running for clothes, seeing me, but you did not do anything when you saw him. He was going in the nude. What is the point? So I am such an old person and you are running after seeing me." Then they said, "You see, he does not have any consciousness of the body." Now immediately a question may come, that does it mean that Vyasa had consciousness of body? Anyway, we don't go to that. Means apparently, comparatively at least, it seems that Shukadeva had lesser consciousness of the body. So he had no consciousness of the body. So we were also not conscious of anything. But the moment you came, we also became conscious because you are conscious of your body. This is the logic. So a person who is not conscious of I, that person cannot think that my body, cannot think that somebody is seeing my body or I am seeing their body. If you don't have the consciousness of I and mine, how can you think it is my body? The very question will not arise. So without the consciousness of I and mine, a person cannot be the agent of knowledge. There is the another example is there. Same Vyasa Deva, he was going to, he went to the, went to meet Shri Krishna. And so all this, all these, what you call, gopis, they gave him a wonderful feast and he ate to his heart's content or more than that. And he went and he was crossing Yamuna. And when Yamuna, he was crossing Yamuna, he went and saw that Yamuna is in full tide. So he went and told Yamuna, Yamuna, if I have not eaten anything, you part way. You give way. So the gopis were also with him. So they saw that Yamuna just gave way. So they said, what is this nonsense? We gave you so much food and now Yamuna, you are saying if I have not eaten, and Yamuna also is giving you way. That means I have no consciousness. Dangerous to get such an eater. Huh? After eating everything, he says, I have not eaten. So anyway, but I have no consciousness. I have no body consciousness. It is not I who has eaten, etc. So this is the thing. If somebody who is truly not in superimposition, if somebody does not have superimposition, as somebody who does not have ignorance, that means that person knows the ultimate reality. If that person knows ultimate reality, that means that person cannot see the body as different, because ultimate reality is infinite. So there can be no two. If that person can see no two, then how can the person see body? How can the person see sense organs? How can the person see mind, intellect, etc.? Nothing that person will see. So the objection was, how can you say that everything pertains to the ignorant? Yes, it pertains to the ignorant, because the wise person who is not in ignorance will not see difference. Will not see difference. And when that person does not see difference, then automatically what happens? That person will not see any agency of knowledge. That person will not consider oneself to be an agent of knowledge. Similarly, pramana pravritti anupapatte. What is pramana? Means of knowledge, proof of knowledge. Pravritti, functioning. So the functioning of the means of knowledge also this person will not see. If a person does not have the identification with the concept of I and mine, how will that person think of direct perception? I hear. How can that happen? I see. The five sense organs. How can that happen? Or how can that person say that inference, which is the second, pratyaksha, anumana, all these different kinds of means of knowledge or proof of knowledge, six methods of knowledge are there. How can a person who does not have the consciousness or the notion of I and mine associate oneself with any of these proofs of knowledge? So that person will not be able to understand, because there is no person. There is no separate individual. So there will be no functioning of the pramana. There will be no functioning of the sit, because who will see whom? There is only one reality. There is no two. So there is no cognizer cognized. See, the Triputi Beda does not exist in the case of a wise person. Pramatra, pramana, prameya. That does not exist. There is no difference. So how will that person see? This is the idea. He indriyani anupadaya na pratyakshadi vyavaharah sambhavati. And because that person will not see, he means indeed. Indriyani anupadaya, without anupadaya, without using upadaya means using, anupadaya means without using. So without using indriyani, sense organs, pratyakshadi vyavaharah na sambhavati. The activity like perception, adi means pratyaksha is the first pramana, pratyaksha, anumana, anupalabdhi, all that. So many pramanas are there, six pramanas are there, shabda, etc., etc. So all these pramanas will not function without what? Without sense organs. Without using of sense organs, how will this function? All pramanas, they are directly or indirectly connected to pratyaksha, direct perception. So pratyaksha, perception, then anumana, यू हैव सीन फायर सम टाइम एंड यू हैव सीन स्मोक, सो यू कनेक्ट स्मोक विथ फायर. यत्र यत्र धूमो तत्र तत्र वाणी. वेर एवर देर इज स्मोक यू अंडरस्टैंड देर इज फायर. देर मे बी एक्सेप्शन बट इन जनरल. सो दैट मीन्स इट इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन वॉट? इट इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन प्रत्यक्ष. सिमिलरली शाब्द प्रमाण. यू से दैट वर्बल टेस्टिमनी बिकॉज ऑफ समबडी हैज टोल्ड. अरे समबडी टोल्ड, यू हैव हर्ड दैट. You have heard it or you have read it. In scriptures it is told, so you have read it. So that also is dependent on direct perception. All these proofs of knowledge are dependent on the functioning or usage of sense organs. A person who is not aware, Sri Ramakrishna was in Nirvikalp Samadhi for how many days? How many days? How many days? 6 months. So 6 months he was in Nirvikalpa Samadhi, you see, and somebody came and fed him and all that, and it seems birds made nest on his head and all. So many things are told and so many things are recorded by Saradanandaji Maharaj in Great Master, Sri Ramakrishna Great Master. So what do we see? When a person has lost his eye consciousness, when a person has lost mind, the body is not existing to that person. In recent times, we know Ramana Maharshi. He simply sat and all his lower body, simply it was eaten by termites. It was eaten by termites. So afterwards, somebody went and they found him, a person sitting like that in Samadhi, and the white ants had eaten away the flesh. That is why since then on, he used to limp, Ramana Maharshi. So you see, Sri Ramakrishna could not take care of his body because he has no consciousness of body. Ramana Maharshi had no consciousness of his body. So that is what will happen to a person who is in knowledge always. Even when that person comes down, that person will not have any much distinction between the ultimate reality and oneself. So when that happens, how can that person see something? How can that person be an agent of knowledge? How can that person use a proof of knowledge? So that's why he says, Indriyani anupadaya pratyakshadi vyavaharah na bhavat sambhavati. Activity, vyavaharah, use of perception, etc. is not possible without the use of sense organs. And अधिष्ठानम अंतरेण इंद्रियाणां व्यवहारेण संभवति. सो विदाउट अ लोकस, यू सी दिस इज द पॉइंट विच इज ब्रॉट हियर. व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय इग्नोरेंस एंड नॉन इग्नोरेंस इन अद्वैत वेदांत? व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय नॉलेज एंड इग्नोरेंस इन अद्वैत वेदांत? वी मीन बाय नॉलेज, वी मीन दैट अ पर्सन हैज गॉट द नॉलेज ऑफ अद्वैत, the truth of non-difference, that the person is knowing jiva brahma aikya, unity of jiva and brahman, non-difference, identity, knowledge of identity. And that is why I told you that then that person will know that there is no space, there is no time, there is no causation. He goes beyond space, time and causation. That avastha we call it turiya. In that case, first he says, space, time and causation is... So if that is the case, then adhishthanam antarena, without a antarena, without adhishthanam, a locus, how can indriyanam vyavaharah sambhavat na sambhavati? Without a locus, in this case body, without a locus, without a place, particular place in space, without the space there can be no activity of sense organs. You see your body and you say, oh, my sense organs. Without the positioning of your body, you cannot think of any functioning of sense organs. It is not possible. So where there is no difference in space, where there is no particular limit in space, how can there be sense organs? And if there is no adhishthana, if there is no locus, how can there be functioning of sense organs? So that means in the case of a person who is not ignorant, this is not possible. Then anadhyasta, 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 atmabhavena dehena na kaschid vyapriyate. Vyapriya means activity. Na kaschid vyapriyate means nobody acts. On what? Ana adhyasta atmabhavena dehena. That means in a body which you don't superimpose yourself with. That means a body in which Atma self is not superimposed, nothing will happen. You see a dead body, it is there, dead body is there. You see, this is the body. Or you see somebody lying in your family, you see somebody sleeping. You're seeing, oh, this person is sleeping. Now you have not superimposed yourself on that body. You have not. So that is why you will not do any activity using that body. It's not possible. Even when you lift that body, you will say, I lifted the body of so and so. When somebody dies, four people are needed, right? Four people are needed. Why only four? No, actually nowadays maybe they put the way in the vehicle and one driver will take away. So four also not needed. But anyway, four people for balance purposes, four people are needed. So four people in the traditional thing, they will take, etc. Nowadays, who takes? Everybody uses a vehicle. They go to electrical crematorium and then just. Anyway, so this somebody is needed to take. Now that person will say, I took the body of such and such person. I took the body of such and such person. Once upon a time in Gujarat, I don't know now, but once upon a time in Gujarat, if they see any dead body going, even in bus they used to remove the slipper. Footwear they will remove. So much of respect they give for dead body. So to get respect, you should die. So you see, this body, unless you superimpose yourself with that body, you don't act using a body. Na kaschid vyapriyate. There is an interesting exercise you can do. When you go to sleep, you will see. When you get up, you should be conscious. Actually, our problem is we are unconscious even while waking. That's the problem. We are not conscious even while waking. Forget about it. You should be conscious all the time. All three states, you should be conscious. Sleeping, dreaming, consciously dream. You should know I am dreaming. You should know now I am entering into sleep. While dreaming also you should know this is dream. Is possible, but don't try some, like they show in this, what you call, they show advertisements and they will write, these are performed by experts, don't try it in your house or something. So don't try something of your own, but this is how you should be. So one thing what you can think is, when you are going into sleep, falling into sleep, you can slowly observe what happens. You will see slowly your body is withdrawing the superimposition. Your mind is withdrawing the superimposition from the body. So when you get up in the morning, means if you get up whenever morning is for you, when you get up, of course you, all of you may get up early, I don't know, but you get up and there you will see slowly only it is possible for you to operate your limbs. You cannot just like that get up and start doing things. It's not possible. So if you are able to do that, means you were lying down awake for a long time. But if you get up from sleep and immediately you cannot do things, you ask a person, you give a person a pen, Even young people, not it's not only for old people or something. Anybody, even a child, you give a pen to that person and say, write, sign. Cannot. Immediately get up, that person will take some time. Or if that person writes also, that letter will all be like somebody with a Alzheimer's disease or Parkinson's disease. It will be very bad. So it takes your central nervous system to come to functioning level for some time it takes. That may be the neurological explanation. What could be the philosophical explanation, Indian philosophical explanation? That is that your mind is now coming to the Jagrata Avastha. So it is now trying to identify with the body. So that is why you might not know, but she might know, is sitting behind you, or Maitreyi ji might know, that in the olden days, they used to say that don't get up quickly from the thing, bed. Then they will say, you, when you get up, you should like that rub your palms, and then you should tell some stotra, some hymn, etc. All these things basically is giving time for you to get up from the bed, so that the coherence returns, because the superimposition of the body has been lost. So it will again, the identification with the body will come. That's why if somebody is, you see, nightmares, why nightmares are so nightmarish? Why is it such a big bad experience? Because you are woken up from sleep without any preparation. And so your heart is beating, everything, and then takes you a lot of time to come to a grip with the situation. So that means even your own body, when you are coming from the subtle state, that is in the dream state, when you are actually associating yourself with a subtle body, only subtle body, and you are not associating yourself with the gross body. Because in dream state you are running, but your body is not running. Body is lying supine. So when that happens, even for coming from your own body, from subtle to the gross, it takes time. And even you cannot use your own body when you are not identified with your own body in the dream sleep state. So that is the case, you see. So only an ignorant person, to the extent of being ignorant in all the three states, that means that person should have an ignorant causal body, ignorant subtle body, and ignorant gross body. Only that person can act. And so Shankaracharya says, Na kaschid vyapriyate, nobody can use the body. Etasmin sarvasmin asati. And when in the case of a person who is completely knowledgeable, asati, these all things are non-existent. What is non-existent? The idea of I, mine is non-existent. The idea of being an agent of knowledge is non-existent. The idea of a proof of knowledge is non-existent. The idea that sense organs are there, it can be used, is non-existent. And there he cannot use, he or she cannot use the means of knowledge. And so there is no locus also. All this, and also there is no superimposition. So nothing is existent, and so asangasya atmanah, unattached self. Self that is not attached, that means knowledgeable. Pramatratvam now upapadyate. No worship does not happen. Now upapadyate is not intelligible, is not cognized. Who will know whom? Who will know whom? Salt doll example. The salt doll went to measure the ocean, but the salt doll became the ocean. Instead of saying salt doll got dissolved in the ocean, that means it could not measure. It became the ocean. It became the ocean. So, like that, Brahmavit Brahmaiva Bhavati. Knower of Brahman becomes Brahman. There's no difference. So, Pramana Pravrittihi also. You see, Pramatrittvam Antarena, without the knowership, and Pramana Pravritti Nasti, without the knowership, there is no Pravritti, functioning of means of knowledge. Nasti, not there. Tasmat, therefore, it is proven that a person who is not ignorant will not get this experience.
So if a person who is not ignorant will not get the experience, it goes without saying that only a person who is ignorant, avidyavat vishayani iva, this all pertains only to avidyavat, people who are ignorant like all of us. Otherwise, why we are reading Brahma Sutra? You are thinking that you are intelligent, that's why you are reading Brahma Sutra. But the news is, you are all foolish, that's why you are reading Brahma Sutra. If you were intelligent, you would not have to read. It's like you have written your name and you are reading, my name is this, my name is Shubha Mukherjee, my name is Shubha Mukherjee, oh, what? So, pratyakshadini, pramanani, shastrani cha. And also not only that this is pertaining to the person who is ignorant, even all this pratyakshadini, means of knowledge, and shastra, everything pertains to the ignorant. Everything pertains to the ignorant. So, it is proved that this whole world, everything pertains to the ignorant. This is what Shankaracharya is saying. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.